Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Once again, greetings to all in the master's name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. This morning, as we are gathering together, this is the time to listen from the word of God. Hallelujah. So I would like to introduce our guest speaker today. We have our dear pastor, P.P. Joseph from Banglore with us this morning to share the word with us. Hallelujah. You know, I just introduced about Pastor P.P. Joseph. He is at present, he is the senior pastor of the IPC Bommasandra Church in Banglore, where I have been pastoring for 5 years. And he is the center minister of IPC Shimoga Center in Karnataka. And also he's the principal of Ebenezer Bible Institute Shimoga. Amen. So Pastor P.P. Joseph is a close friend of mine and a useful vessel in the hands of God in the previous many years. And I believe God is going to speak to us through his servant, and let us be prayerfully sit in the presence of God. We are so happy to welcome Pastor P.P. Joseph in our midst, and let's all put our hands together and welcome the man of God with us, and he is going to share the word of God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Can you hear me?
Praise the Lord, Pastor. We can hear you.
Praise the Lord. I thank and praise God for this beautiful day that God has given to us to come together to worship the Lord in truth and spirit in this manner through this Zoom platform. First of all, I bring greetings to you all from my family, from the city of Bangalore, and also from our local church, Indian Pentecost Church of God, Gilgal Bommasandra. It's my joy and pleasure to be with you this evening here, but there morning, to worship together. I thank Pastor Samguti and his family and all church members for giving me this opportunity to share from the Word of God. Pastor Samguti is a very close friend to me. I know him from many years. God gave us opportunity to study together in Abram Bible College, Kumanad, Kerala, India. From that day onwards, we have good relationship. We work together in the state of Karnataka for many years. As I said earlier, he was pastor of our church for the last 5 years before he came to United States. He was pastoring here, our church, for the past 5 years. He's having a good reputation in our state, in our church. He was a model pastor in our state. I know them, as I said, for many years. Sister Grace, their children, Albi and Aksa. It's very joy to see you all this morning time. As we come close in the presence of God, it's really joy and it's an excitement to be in his presence and worship the Lord. We are his children. We are his sheep. God called and separated us to be his own. God sent his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, to redeem us from the bondage of the slavery of the sin. He purchased us, so we are his own, we are his property. We belong to Jesus Christ, we belong to God. So it's very joy to be called as the children of God. God so loved us to be called as the children of God. Hallelujah. That's the greatest privilege that we ever get on this earth, to be called as the children of God. Hallelujah. We are one in Christ. though we are scattered in different continents, but we are one in Christ. Though we speak different languages, we come from different family background, we speak different languages, but still we are one in Christ. We belong to the body of Christ. Hallelujah. That's the joy that we have. The worldly people do not understand this, but it's a great privilege to know each other, to have a good relationship. Hallelujah. God always wants us to have good fellowship with Him and also to have good fellowship with one another. Hallelujah. That's the structure that God has given in our life. Hallelujah. Because God created human beings in His own image and in His likeness. God has deposited His divine nature in our life. The New Testament believers, we receive the divine nature through our Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So it's very joy to be in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. The message that I'm going to bring to you, the topic or the theme of my message is the joy of the Lord that is promised to the believers of Christ. Hallelujah. Praise the joy of the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You know the difference between happiness and joy. Happiness. Happiness is the happiness that we get according to the situations and circumstances. When something happens in our life that brings happiness in our life, that will not last for long time. That's for a temporary time being. But the joy of the Lord will last forever. Hallelujah. Because He is eternal. Because He is always with us. The joy will be in us. Hallelujah. The text that I selected for today's message is the book of Nehemiah, chapter 8. Verse 10. My daughter Mariam Susan Joseph will help me in reading the Bible portions. Nehemiah chapter 8, verse 10.
Nehemiah said, "Go and enjoy choice food and sweet drinks, and send some to those who have nothing prepared. This day is sacred to our Lord. Do not grieve, for the joy of the Lord is your strength."
Yes, do not grieve, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. Hallelujah. We all know about the book of Nehemiah. We know about Nehemiah. He was a man of God. He was a prayer warrior. He was a very faithful man. And he was a very righteous man in the sight of the Lord. Because of the lack of time, I can't elaborate all the history or background of this book, but still I would like to touch each and every chapter of the book of Nehemiah so that you can understand the whole story of the book of Nehemiah and how they were joined in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. We know that the book of Nehemiah starts with weeping, crying, praying, and fasting. When he studied the history or the situation of the city of Jerusalem, the pathetic condition of the city of Jerusalem, how the people were in turmoil, how the people were in difficulty and mourning in the city of Jerusalem. Because that city was destroyed by Nebuchadnezzar years ago. So the wall of the city was destroyed. Its doors were put in fire, and there was heaps of rubbles were there in the city of Jerusalem. So the condition was very pathetic condition. When some brothers came from the city of Jerusalem to the place where Nehemiah was, the citadel of Susa, they reported what they saw in the city of Jerusalem. He inquired about the remnants who were in the city of Jerusalem. So they gave a report which was not so pleasing. When he heard the message from them or the report they gave, so he began to cry in the presence of God. He began to weep in the presence of God. He took fasting. He knelt before God. See, the chapter 1 began with crying, weeping, fasting, and praying. But in chapter 8, we see it became joy in the presence of God. Hallelujah. Praise God. The weeping and crying will not last forever. It is temporary, but the joy of the Lord will last forever. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. See, the first chapter was the chapter of preparation. So there was a preparation. Chapter 1. So we see what are the preparation they have done, especially Nehemiah. He was a cupbearer in the court of Ahasuerus, the king Ahasuerus. So he was very faithful. That's why they appointed him as a cupbearer. But still, though he had a good job in that dynasty, in that court, but still he was very pious, and he was so righteous, and he was very humble, and he was very prayerful man. His mind was always in the city of Jerusalem, because he knew that there were exiles in the city in Susa or in Babylon, so they have to go back to Jerusalem one day or the other day. So he was eagerly waiting for them. He was eagerly waiting an opportunity to go back and rebuild the walls of Jerusalem. So in the first chapter, we see it was a preparation. And even in the chapter 2, we see, in chapter 2 also, we see he's presenting that matter to the king. He's presenting the project that is going to do to the king Ahasuerus. Because he reported everything to the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. First, he reported all the things, what he's going to do ahead. He reported to the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. Then he presented this project to the king. Hallelujah. Dear children of God, whatever situation you are going, whatever project that God wants you to do in the days to come, first of all, you kneel before the Lord. You cry unto the Lord. Take fasting and pray in the presence of God. God will open the doors. Hallelujah. Though it seems impossible in your sight, God will make it possible. Hallelujah. We know that the situations and circumstances, it was not possible at all, because they were slaves in Babylon. But because he knelt down before the Lord, he cried in the presence of the Lord, God began to open the hearts of kings and officers in the land of Susa. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Our God is a miracle-working God. Hallelujah. God can do anything in any circumstances, in any country, in any place. Hallelujah. It's not a matter to God, the place or the situations or circumstances. Hallelujah. We know that we are under difficult times. We are undergoing the pandemic period. It's very difficult time all over the world, not particularly in one country or in one particular city. Hallelujah. We are in difficult times. If you pray unto the Lord, God can change the things. Hallelujah. He is in control of everything. Hallelujah. First of all, what we have to do is we have to look unto the Lord as we read in Psalms 34, those who look unto the Lord, their faces will never cover with shame. Hallelujah. Their faces will be radiant. Hallelujah. Because we look unto the Lord, who is the Lord of the lights. Hallelujah. Praise God. Because He is the Lord of the lights, is the God of lights. Hallelujah. That radiant lights will flash upon our lives. So we will be radiant. We will never put to shame. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. See, that preparation, first two chapters with preparation for the work that they are going to do ahead, or for the project that they are going to do. And chapter 3, we see he got a good cooperation from the fellow beings. He got a good cooperation. That cooperation, we see, if you go through that old chapter, the priests, the Levites, the goldsmiths, the merchants, and the ordinary people, everyone, they did their own work according to their capacity, according to their ability. They invested their money, they invested their time, they invested their wisdom and knowledge, whatever God gave to their life. Hallelujah. Dear children of God, we have to invest for the kingdom of God, whatever God has given, God has deposited in our life. Hallelujah. Through the wisdom that God has given in our life, through the work ability that God has given in our life, through the knowledge, through the education that God has given in our life, hallelujah, according to the capacity or the ability that God has given in our life, we have to invest it for the kingdom of God. Then the work will be done very easily. Hallelujah. Nowadays, why the work is not being done fastly, we are not using our abilities and the wisdom and the knowledge and the money and the character, the divine nature, or what all God has deposited in your life, that we are not investing in a proper way, in a right time, in a right way. Why? That's the reason the work is not completed. Hallelujah. There, they did not waste the time. They did not waste the time. They took every opportunity as valuable. Hallelujah. In this pandemic period, God has given good opportunity to prepare ourselves to go ahead to do the project that what God wants us to do through our lives. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. God has called each and everybody with a purpose. Hallelujah. When God called each and everybody, He called us with a purpose. God did not call us without any purpose. If God is called with a purpose, what the work I had to do, I have to do in the right time, in the lifetime that God has given the time to live on this earth. Hallelujah. Whether it may be a short period or long period, we don't know. Whether it may be 50 years or 60 years or 80 years or 90 years, we don't know. The lifespan that God has given to live on this earth, the time will pass away very soon. We should not be regret. At last, we couldn't do anything for the kingdom of God. So this is the right time to invest for the kingdom of God. Whatever God has entrusted you, whatever God has deposited in your life, be faithful. Be committed for that. So here, beginning from priests to the ordinary people, the Levites, by claim, they repaired the gates and put the bars and they built the wall, okay, in front of their houses. So they had good cooperation. They worked along with the servant of God, Nehemiah, under the leadership of Nehemiah. So you see, in chapter 2, when you go through the chapter 2, I don't have the time to elaborate. When you go back to chapter 2, we see that the things what all wanted there to build the rebuild the wall, God gave in a miraculous way. He wanted the letters to give to the kings in Transjordan, and he wanted the army, he wanted cavalry, and he wanted some officers with him. So what all the needs he wanted, God gave him. Hallelujah. When he prayed in the presence of God, God opened the door. Hallelujah. Don't think that I lack everything. I don't have such and such thing. I don't have money. I don't have the things to do. I have the mind to do, but I don't have the things to do. If you kneel before the Lord, if you pray, if you pray in the presence of God, God will open the door. He opened the heart of the king and officers. If you pray and fast in the presence of God, God can open the doors of hearts of many people, so that they will come to you and tell and ask, what do you want to do for the kingdom of God? Hallelujah. You see, when he went to pour the wine to the king himself said, why your face is so sad? It's not because of your illness. He knew Nehemiah. His face was not so sad like this before. He was so sad because he couldn't tolerate when he heard the report of Jerusalem. We should have the burden about the kingdom of God. We should have the burden that what God wants you to do in your presence. Just kneel before the Lord and ask God, Lord, how can I be benefited for the kingdom of God? In what way I can invest myself in your kingdom of God? You may be telling, I'm not a pastor, I'm not an evangelist, I'm not an apostle, I'm not a servant of God. I'm just here doing some job in companies or in hospital, in medical field or whatever it may be. God wants you to do in that place. God can use you miraculously in that place. Hallelujah. Let me proceed. Hallelujah. But in chapter 4 to 6, from chapter 4 to 6, we see there was a great opposition also. In the beginning, the situation was favorable. In the beginning, the situation was favorable. The king was favored to him. The officers were favored to him. He got the materials for that. He got good encouragement. Okay. He got, in chapter 3, we see the cooperation with the co-workers or co-people or fellow men. But in chapter 4 to 6, we see the opposition from the enemies. You know, Sanballat and Tobiah. Okay, they opposed severely. They ridiculed. They said, what these feeble Jews can do? So they were telling them, these Jews were feeble people. They thought there are few in numbers. What can they do? They don't have muscle power. They don't have other things that they can do. They thought they were very feeble, but they didn't knew one thing. The enemies did not knew that their God is with them. Hallelujah. People may think that we are very feeble people. Feeble. We are not strong. But if God is with us, no one can be against us. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. If he is with us, no one can be against us. Hallelujah. So they knew that God is, the enemies did not understand that, but Nehemiah and his people knew one thing, their God is with them. Hallelujah. First of all, they ridiculed them. Secondly, they told to have a compromise. And then at last they thought, it's not working. They already half built. Then last strategy, they thought to wage war against them. But they were vigilant. Half of the workers, they were working. And half of them were very vigilant. They were watching. They had torch with their hands. They had knife with their hands. They had spear with their hands. They were cautious in their work. Hallelujah. Dear children of God, God, if God is with us, don't be afraid of the enemies. Don't be afraid of the strategies of enemy. Hallelujah. Of course, when we start with one strategy, evil the enemies will come with another strategy. Don't worry. Hallelujah. But God will be with us and God will give us victory. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. What I'm trying to tell you is, even though they started with cry, weeping, fasting, prayer, they had to do really hard work, but at last there was joy in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. It led them to the joy, yes, situation in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. Chapter 4 to 6, I say it was, there was great opposition. They said that, Tobias said, let them work, but if a fox jumped upon this wall, it will be collapsed. So they thought the wall of Jerusalem, what they are constructing, is very weak. They can easily destroy them. But they built a strong wall. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. See, they completed the work within 52 days. They took only 52 days to complete the work of the, to rebuild the wall of Jerusalem. Hallelujah. They did not think of that. The enemies never expected in that way, because God was with them. Because God gave the project in their mind. Because God directed them. God gave them the resources. By the help of God, they began to work. We know many discouragements were there among the Jews, because from the four sides, these enemies began to tell, you can't do that, we will attack you. See, they were hearing from the four sides. When they heard these discouraging words, they began to, their strength began to become weak. And they said, we can't do that. They are going to attack us. But Nehemiah encouraged them, strengthened them. Hallelujah. Through the word of God, through the promise of God. Because he knew what he's going to do. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. God has deposited something in his heart. God has given a vision in his heart that he knows that God is going to fulfill that. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Dear children of God, if you stand with the pastor, with the servant of God, with the leader of the church, if you cooperate with the church leader, God is going to do great things in your church. Hallelujah. Praise God. The church pastor, the leader of the church, will be having a vision. God has given some, God has deposited some projects in his heart. Praise God. Sometimes he only knew that. He might have presented that to the church. But if you join with him, though it seems impossible in the beginning, if you join with him, if you join your hands with him, if you join your hearts with him, God is able to do many things, great things. Hallelujah. It might have not done in the previous days or years, but God can do in the days to come. Hallelujah. How many of you believe this? Hallelujah. It's a word of prophecy that God has given this morning time. Hallelujah. I believe that God is going to do great and mighty things through the servant of God and with the partners, prayer partners, those who are in this church. Hallelujah. Okay. From chapter 7 to 10, we see the celebration. Hallelujah. The opposition did not work out. So at last we see the the celebration. Hallelujah. Praise God. See, the weeping and crying became celebration in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. If you weep in the presence of God, if you cry in the presence of God, there is a day of celebration ahead of you. Hallelujah. Praise God. That's not so far. It's very near. It's very near. There is celebration. Hallelujah. See, in chapter 8, we see that Ezra, the scribe, the priest, he stood on a platform and he began to read from the scripture. And the Levites were standing at his right and left. They began to interpret the scriptures. Hallelujah. The law of Moses. When they heard the meaning of the scriptures, they began to cry in the presence of God. Their hearts were broken. Their hearts were stirred up and they began to cry in the presence of God, because they understood why these things happen in their life. Hallelujah. They understood the reason behind all these calamities in their life. Dear children of God, when you really read the word of God, when you really understand the message of God, then only your hearts will be stirred up and you will break in the presence of God and cry in the presence of God. Hallelujah. So they began to repent in the presence of God. They began to confess their sins in the presence of God. Hallelujah. My dear children of God, when you receive the word of God, we should realize who we are. What is our situation? What is our condition? What are the sins that we have done in the presence of God? There are sin of omission, there are sin of commission. We have to confess in the presence of the Lord. That began a revival in their midst. Hallelujah. The revival comes only from the word of God. Hallelujah. It's not from the outward noise or outward expressions. It should come from within. It should come from within our hearts. When the word of God penetrates in our heart and breaks our heart, the repentance comes out, the revival comes forward. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So repent in the presence of God when we hear the word of God. So they repented. They cried unto the Lord. They realized because of the sins they have done, they had to face all these turmoils, all the difficulties, all the calamities they faced in their homeland and also in the place where they were exiled. So now when they were crying and weeping and confessing their sins, Ezra, Nehemiah, and many servants of God, Levites, came to them and said, this is Lord's day, or this day is sacred day for you all. Do not weep, do not grieve. So what you have to do? You have to, the joy of the Lord is your strength. Hallelujah. The joy of the Lord is your strength. Hallelujah. So our strength is in the joy of the Lord. Hallelujah. So they said, go and distribute the sweets and the food materials to a neighborhood. That was their experience. In those days, when the celebrations were doing, distributing the food products to other people. So the fullness of the joy will come only in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. So when we feel the presence of God, when the word of God is in our heart, when you feel the presence of God, then only the fullness of joy will come out of your life. Hallelujah. Let's look to Psalms 16 and verse 11. Psalms 16 and verse 11.
You have made known to me the path of life.
Yes.
You will fill me.
You will fill me
with joy.
With joy
in your presence.
In your presence. You will fill me with joy in your presence. Hallelujah. You will fill me with joy in your presence. Yes.
With
eternal pleasures at your right hand. Hallelujah. So you will fill me with joy in your presence. Or your presence is fullness of joy. At your right hand are pleasures forever. Hallelujah. In the beginning I said the happiness is for a short period. But the joy of the Lord will last forever. It's forever and ever. Hallelujah. There are many verses to read, but because of lack of time, I'm going to wind up. Hallelujah. Psalms 126 and verse 5 says, they that sow in tears shall reap in joy. Hallelujah. So those who sow in tears shall reap in joy. The beginning is what? Tears. And lastly, we see the joy. Hallelujah. Praise God. See, Jesus said to his disciples, and ye shall, in John chapter 16, verse 24, and ye shall receive that your joy may be full. Hallelujah. John 16, 24.
Until now, you have not asked for anything in my name.
In my name. Then
ask and you will receive.
Ask and you will receive.
And your joy will be complete.
And your joy will be complete. See, when we ask in the presence of God, our joy will be complete. Hallelujah. I'm going forward. In Romans chapter 14, verse 17 says, Romans 14, 17. Yeah.
For the kingdom of God is not a matter of eating and drinking, but of righteousness,
peace,
and joy in the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah. And joy in the Holy Spirit. We belong to the kingdom of God. We have entered into the kingdom of God. So the kingdom of God is not a matter of eating or drinking, but righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Praise God. When we fill in the Holy Spirit, when we are led by the Spirit, the joy is different. Hallelujah. So my time is up. Hallelujah. We are having an everlasting joy to come. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, praise God. In Psalms 30, verse 5 says, but the joy cometh in the morning. The lamentation will be in the night, but the joy cometh in the morning. That shows the lamentation, the cry and weeping is temporary, but the joy will come in the morning. There is a morning, there is a dawn ahead of us. Hallelujah. Today, if you are mourning, today, if you are weeping, today, if you are in grief, hallelujah, your mourning will become into joy. Hallelujah. It will turn into joy. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. In Isaiah chapter 35, verse 10 says, come to Zion with songs and everlasting joy and gladness, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away. Hallelujah. Today, you may be facing, sorrow and sighing. Hallelujah. There may be sadness in your life. There may be sorrows in your life. There may be difficulties in your life. But come to Zion with songs and everlasting joy. Hallelujah. When we enter into Zion, hallelujah, our joyness will be it will be everlasting. Praise the Lord. Let me conclude here, my dear brothers and sisters, servants of God. Hallelujah. Nehemiah started with crying and weeping, praying and fasting. But in chapter 8, we see that the joy of the Lord became their strength. Praise the Lord. But they had to undergo a process in their life. You may be in such a process in your life. Hallelujah. Oh, the enemy's strategies may be coming one after the other in your life. But don't worry. God is with you. Hallelujah. God is going to do some new things in your life, through your life, through the abilities and the resources that God has deposited in your life. Hallelujah. God use you mightily in the days to come for the glory of God. God may use you for the extension of the kingdom of God. Let the church, eternal life, church of God, be a blessing to the nation, to all the people of God all over the world. Hallelujah. Once again, I thank the church pastor and all the committee members and all the children of God for giving me this opportunity. Thank you, thank you, thank you very much. My children, Joel, Joseph, and Mariam, Susan, Joseph, two children, God has blessed the two children. They are going to sing a song to you. Thank you, God bless. For our family, my wife Susan Joseph, my son Joel Joseph, my daughter Mariam Susan Joseph, pray for ministry. God bless you.